Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another War Thunder. I don't know if this will be an announcement video or an upcoming content video, but as you can see, surprise attack in one... Wait, 1 hour? It hasn't been 24 hours yet. What? Okay, I'm going to just point this out for the record that at about 2 in the morning, or not 2 in the morning, at about 2 p.m. yesterday... I checked the time, and it said 1 day and 7 hours remaining. It is now only 5 in the morning the next day, and it already says 1 hour. Kind of freaking me out a little bit. I've passed over into a parallel dimension. Anywho, they released, a day or two ago, they released a little teaser video. Obviously for the April Fools. I actually received an email about this. It's definitely, without a doubt, I didn't think anything of it other than April Fool's. I mean, planning something a day before April Fool's, and it's going to be amazing, and April Fool's, obviously. But we got to remember, April Fool's for Gaijin is no longer a time for fun and jokes, it's a time for testing a new primary mechanic or a new type of vehicle. For example, they tested naval forces with the sailing ships. The next year, they tested rank 6 ground vehicles. This year, it looks like they are testing one of either two different things, or both. Well, it looks like this year we are getting to test submarines in War Thunder. But not just any submarines. These are nuclear submarines, guys. Nuclear submarines, alright? Not only that, not only are they submarines, nuclear... Okay, now, first of all, let me just point out, I was not expecting this. I was expecting the teaser video to be showing off guided missiles fired from nothing more than modern jets. I think most of us were expecting to see modern aviation, rank 6 aviation, with update 1 point, or not update, excuse me, with 2018's April Fools. Looks like that is not the case. But let's go ahead and read and see what they say. Well, first, let's watch the video. It's actually a really badass video. Silent Thunder. Oh boy. In clashes between three of the major military powers of the 21st century, players will battle against each other in combat in some of the world's most powerful nuclear submarines. The three-dimensional depths of the ocean, realistic physics, and modern strategic weaponry will become available this weekend. All players will be able to take part in the initial first test. The test session will be held from 12 GMT on March 31st until 12 GMT on April 3rd. In the test version of the game, players will be able to try modern nuclear submarines from the three major military powers, the United States, Great Britain, and Russia, where each vessel is armed with a unique selection of guided torpedoes and missiles. Guided torpedoes, guarded torpedoes, and missiles. Okay, I'll get on to why I emphasize that. The test will be held in a location inspired by the Spitsbergen ocean area. Players will be able to capture one of the strategic zones, and once it's captured, cruise or ballistic missiles will be launched. Ooh, special, special. Among the powerful armament of the Russian Yasin, I don't know, whatever class, for example, are the destructive 3M14K caliber, I don't know fucking words, of different languages. Come on, throw me a bone here. Anti-ship and land attack cruise missiles, famous from their presence in recent conflicts. The only British nuclear missile platform, Vanguard class, excels in its guided anti-submarine torpedo armament, and at a weight of 2 tons, each boasts unparalleled anti-submarine power. The American Virginia class may have less potent torpedoes on offer, but more than makes up for it with nuclear warheads, each with a yield of up to 200 kilotons, fitted on dozens of the famous Tomahawk missiles. Silent Thunder aims for a completely new vehicular combat experience, deep down below in the dark... Okay, let me rephrase this. Deep down where whales creep... in the world's oceans, players will be able to navigate and detect enemies using sonar and other detection devices, while trying to stay hidden from the ever-watchful eye of their enemies. The slightest sound can reveal their location, so players need to be careful when activating their sonar, firing a torpedo, even scraping their outer hull against a rock or iceberg can give away... Wait, rocks... Are there any islands that are just sheer cliffs underwater? I mean, I guess if you're off a drop-off, a little ways away from a beach, but I don't know. Learn something new every day. This is a game for true naval tacticians. I'll tell you what. If you put whales in this game, I will fucking uninstall your game in a heartbeat. You hear me? No fucking whales. Absolutely fucking not. You hear me? Break the chilling silence in the Arctic Ocean this weekend. And that's it. So what? Why did I emphasize the two things they'll be testing? Guided torpedoes and missiles. Well, I think the most obvious thing that they may be testing here is submarines. They may be testing submarines for naval forces. They've already talked about it in the past. I honestly don't see them ever saying, I don't see them not doing it. I don't see them not doing a test on it, at least. This could be a test. This may double as a test for submarines, but also guided torpedoes and missiles, that's certainly a test for guided weaponry. They're testing guided weaponry to see how that works, but they're disguising it by making it a submarine-based thing and not an air-to-air guided missile system or something like that. I think they'll test their guided torpedo system and base the statistics from the test for their testing on guided air-to-air missiles or ground-to-air or air-to-ground missiles. In my opinion, at least. It just seems the most logical. This would be the third year in a row that they're testing things, and there's only two things they're doing, guided weaponry and submarines. They could be testing both. They could be testing one. If I had to say they're testing one, I would say it's the guided weapon system. I would say that over the submarines. But they may be testing both. This certainly may be... And now we're not talking, of course, nuclear submarines coming to the game, but remember last time, rank 6 was being tested, or rank 9, should I say, modern tanks. And we ended up getting rank 6 added to the game. T-80 or T-90 and no frickin' Leopard 2A5 or whatever it was that was being tested. No helicopters or anything, but, and they're saying that they consider helicopters. They are considering helicopters, so who knows? Feel free in the comments below to tell me what you guys think, if you think this is going to be a submarine test, or if this is a guided weapon test, or if this is actually a test for both. I would like to believe it's a test for both. I think submarine combat, not only would it be interesting, but it's actually really, really unique. How many games, like War Thunder, allow you to actually command and control submarines? That's something that I don't think World of Warships has. That could be something that'll give you the upper hand. But, I don't know. We'll have to see. And submarines are fucking badass. I mean, if you look in here, when the submarine just emerges out of the water... Excuse me. Right here. That is epic as all hell. Okay. So, I'll be eager to see. And this may actually be the first time I play War Thunder in weeks. Absolute weeks. We'll have to see. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Don't forget, let me know what you think this is a test of. Again, is it a test for submarines? Is it a test for guided weapon systems? Or is it a test for both? I'll see you guys in the next upcoming War Thunder content video.